I'm making my speech out of my pocket.
Which pocket?
First, I'm gonna say, the hell were you guys thinking? You guys have any idea what you just did? Seriously, did you at all? So, this morning, get up for breakfast, go to the fridge, go to get the milk, and I see the invitation for the wedding on the refrigerator, and I said, oh shit, that's today. And I gotta make a speech. So, my speech isn't that great, it's because I made it over Cinnamon Toast Crunch and eggs. So, all joking aside, Callie, you couldn't have asked a better person to marry you. Despite everybody in the world telling you not to get married, you guys went and did, you know, what a lot of people look for their whole life, trying to find true love. And you guys found it in each other.
Yeah, man.
Definitely. So, basically, you guys found somebody who will put up with each other for the rest of their lives. That's what you guys found in each other. And I think I speak on behalf of everybody in this room when I say, we wish you a long, happy marriage, and raise your toast, bless your toast, all right? To Mr. and Mrs. Zachary George.
Let's hear it for our best man, Charles, tonight. Last but not least in our toast, I'd like to call on our maid of honor, Natalie, to give our final toast for this evening. So once again, give her your attention right up here at our sweetheart table.
Makeup. We have a sense of taste in that. But it wasn't always rainbows and unicorns with Callie. As all my brothers know, I have quite an extensive criteria for approval. And I'll be honest, when you first brought her home, I thought she was gonna be a handful. I thought for sure she was gonna give a run for his money. She was an only child. She had big blonde hair and a new designer bag every time she showed up. Gucci, Fendi, Louboutin. You know, they do say you'll marry your brother. And I knew Zach always liked the, for lack of a better word, bitchier type. Judge Judy was his favorite. Every time she was on TV, he watched her. So I knew why he fell for her. She never had a problem telling him when his outfits were out of date. In fact, one time, he was only allowed to have Calvin Klein designer jeans. But I couldn't have been more wrong with my first impression. Like I said earlier, beautiful, driven, and a perfect match. Her beauty speaks for herself, her big green eyes, her flawless skin, and her dark, dark hair, long hair. And her drive is second to none. They met in college. She finished her 150 credits in her first 4 years at TCNJ and was a licensed CPA within a year later. Something I admire. As time passed, they moved in together, and they would visit on Sundays where Zach would care to the lawn maintenance, and Callie would study with her self-made note cards. They bought a house and are now married 6 months after engagement. She always had a grand plan, a structure, when things were going to happen. And by the way, last time we spoke, 3 to 4 years before kids, so if anybody's don't look around. But she knows this is not going to happen. She knows what she wants, and she's going to get what she wants. And a perfect match. And with all this, I give you my place not only as half's other half, but as better half. To Callie.